Hey, what's going on, guys? Dano here, and today we're playing War Thunder. Before I show you the replay, I want to go over a few things. If you go to menu, go to controls, go to view controls, and go down to binoculars, this will let you look through your binoculars as if left break. And so that will, if you press that B button, you will get a clearer view range. You'll be zoomed in farther. And you can also move your gunner to where you're looking. So that's good. Let's hit OK. Now, another thing I heard is if you go to controls, go to, I think it's tank control. Yeah, range finder set to R. So I already have it. I already have my range finder set. So what that'll do is if you look at a target and you press R and you hold it, it'll detect the range and it'll tell you about how far away the target is away from you, which will help you with your aim assistance. So now on to the replay. So here we are, and I am in C-34-85 with my big bug eyes on the side of the tank. There. But this episode of RB is all about patience. If you notice, patience can actually win you the game and get you some good rewards, some very nice rewards. So this is probably my favorite tank, D-34-85. So what I'm going to do is, I like to do this in lots of videos, go up to, or lots of places, go up to a certain spot on the map, and then find a place where I can just sit there and I guess camp. Not usually very long, I don't ever spawn camp, but I mean just like camp more on the choke points, where your enemy needs to come through. Now again, if I've stated before, those little red name tags, you play the actual game, you can't actually see those people. And they can't see me because they're too far away. They're realistic. You can't actually see people very well. So I'm going to check out the cap. And I kind of decide that, you know, maybe I'll sit here and protect the cap for a while. Well, maybe not. So what I go ahead and do is I start heading for these forest animals. You can probably guess what I do now. Get over to my favorite spot, and then I sit and wait. Yes, I sit. I also sat here because the M18 flanking the stupid Hellcats. Also that. So, if you think that a tank is dead, and you don't know if it's dead or not, fire your machine gun at it. That'll let you know, it'll say hit, and if it's still alive, you know, then you probably should take, and if it isn't, it'll probably take the time to aim for its weak spot. Alright, I always, always go for ammo racks in this. It's almost a guaranteed one shot if I go for an ammo rack with this. I'm also extremely threatening because I have big bug eyes. Now, some matches don't last that long. And I mean, some matches can last for about 30-40 minutes, depending on how much weed the opponent gets. And here I'm almost completely concealed. And my enemy team, or the enemy team, our team is trying to push. Surprisingly, nobody's in a plane. Most people are in anti-aircraft. Now, the enemy is not in a plane either. They're all in tanks still. So what are we doing? Sitting and waiting. I figured out that the majority of things that I die from in this game are Hellcats. They are very good at getting on your flank. The only downside of them is that they have, I mean, like, their armor was probably made out of bed sheets. I mean, it's terrible. So you can usually easily one-shot it, or I can at least easily one-shot it. Okay. So I decided to move to this little tree cover right here. Now, one of my pet peeves in this game are fences. Of course, this was before I discovered that you can use binocular view and range finding. Oh, wow, an enemy wyvern. If you don't know what the wyvern is, it is really, really good. It carries 15 rockets. It's insane. It's one of the best planes, attack aircraft in the game. So I'm moving up on the enemy's capture point. Look around. Just sitting and waiting. Of course, I'm sure that some of your people watching this, your patience is running thin. You'll see it if you wait, there's gonna be a whole lot more action. We have a bomb in here. So I decided to start looking around the capture point. Now, these rounds here, these high explosive rounds are amazing. As you can see, they one shot whatever they hit. They're just like so versatile. I mean, like, you can just destroy tanks with this thing. And a M6 jumbo over here. I'm surprised they found one. Got his weak spot. Nailed him. Still face tanking. One shot again. See what I mean? This tank is really good in the right hands. Really good. It just all depends on you being in the right place at the right time, like I was. In the end, you got that. There's a miss. This was probably one of my better games. I did get a game one time where I got 7 kills. That was good. So now we got a Captain KB2. Now this isn't like World War VI. If you shoot somebody in the cap and they don't die, it does not have 7 kills. You keep capping. Of course, KB2 can face tank for me. I don't know what on earth the enemy. Let's see, where is it? I think it's the Achilles doing that. It's just firing its machine gun all over the place. I don't know how you're gonna penetrate KB2 with a machine gun unless you're like a ZSU, but you're not gonna see those in this PR. It's way too high. I can hit the stinky guy. That's interesting. Oh, got his cannon breach, he can't fire. Well, he can try to, or it might explode inside the tank. What did I shoot? Was that a Hellcat shot? No, that was the Achilles. I see him coming. Oh, there's another hit. Let's see, you got the... So he's completely immobilized now. Nope, someone got him before I did. So I can go ahead and move into a capture point. But this tank's good, decent mobility. They're, the, medium Soviet tanks are like some of the most balanced tanks in the game. I mean, like, really good gun, good armor, good mobility. They're just like all around. They're like jack of all trades type tanks. They got a little bit of everything. You see earlier, I was bouncing shots from an Achilles. So now we're just capping the enemy team while the Wyvern runs all over the place. What is that Wyvern? Is he truly trying to go after a PE2? Yeah, I'm gonna be, I'll probably get one of these soon. Oh, he's got a Yak 9 on his back. Yeah, he's pretty neat. Now he's gonna overshoot. We're still in the capture point. We're almost done capping. And as soon as we start capping, you can watch that little red bar at the top, middle. Watch it, watch how fast it goes down. Once you've capped. Yeah, pretty quick. Yeah, now we're gonna go for our friendly Austin, I think. So yeah, that's the game. I got, I did really good that round. I mean, I got first place on my team. I got Steel Fury Award. It was great. So I hope y'all enjoyed. If you did, please put a like and a comment below. If you want to see more of my stuff, then subscribe and hit the notification button, which looks like a little bell next to the subscribe button. And I hope you have a wonderful Sunday. I'll see you guys later. Bye.